What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Today we are talking about something that is better than base plates. You did read the title correct. It is not Lego, but it is something that's better than base plates. I'm going to tell you all about these and why you should be using them in your city, and it starts right now. All right, guys, so before we really dive in, you guys know that we are Lego purists to a fault for the most part. There's been a few products here and there, like the Strictly Briks curve that we put in our city recently. But for the most part, everything that you see in our city is 100% pure Lego, and we don't go outside of those constraints. However, you probably also saw recently that Lego is intending to raise prices, and that kind of hit us in the wrong way. For me and for Miss AFOL TV, you know, a lot of people in the country are already being pinched by high gas prices, inflation, and everything else. And for Lego to come out and raise prices on something that's already really overpriced, in my opinion, it's a really expensive hobby and a really expensive toy. It doesn't seem right to me. So for that reason, I think it's time to start considering other options. Not that we're ditching Lego as a whole. 99% of our city will still be Lego, but I think that there is a void in an area in which it does make sense to branch outside of pure Lego elements. And this is one of them. So what am I talking about? Well, these are not Lego. These are technically base plates. More on that in a minute, because they're a little bit different than base plates, but they're made by a company called Strictly Briks. It's a family out of Wisconsin that created the company, and it's made in India, but obviously distributed here, and I believe it's available elsewhere in the world. But what's great about these is it solves a couple problems, and being able to solve not just one, but multiple problems all in one product, for me, that's a huge win. So let's go through the problems that these things solve and what we're using them for. Well, for starters, these are much thicker than base plates. What these are actually a thickness of a Lego plate, not a base plate. So if you compare it to a true Lego plate, it is the exact same width. And it's 32 by 32 studs. So it's the size and the dimensions of a base plate, but the thickness is as thick as a Lego plate. So if you're looking at these and you compare them to Lego's largest plate, which is 16 by 16, you can lay out four traditional Lego 16 by 16 plates on here and basically create the same thing, or you can just buy one of these and you have essentially four Lego plates in one. So what are the advantages of that? Well, for starters, a traditional 16 by 16 stud plate is really expensive. This is a really expensive piece of plastic. So if I pull it up on BrickLink, and you can do this with any part in the Lego catalog, but if you pull it up on BrickLink and you search, you can also look at the average sales price over the last 6 months. So the average sales price for one of these 16 by 16 plates is $3.30. $3.30 for one piece of plastic. That is insane. So if you have to use four of these to make one of these plates, you're spending over $13 to make one of these. That is crazy, especially if you're laying out a city, which by comparison, you get a pack of six of these, three greens, three blues, they have other colors available for about 14 bucks. So that is about $2 and some change per base plate. And again, it's four of these. So $2 versus, I can't remember, it was about $13 for four of these. I mean, come on. But that's not the only benefit. Now, Lego came out with their new road plate system last year, and it's been kind of controversial with a lot of people. It grew on us. When it first came out, we weren't huge fans, but after playing around with it and building some different road layouts, we decided to go with that layout for our whole city. With that, you obviously have to raise up buildings, including Lego's own modular builds, because they're built on the old style base plates at base plate level. So if you actually want to bring it up to the road level, you have to add spacing beneath. And it's usually a plate on top of a brick. So it's basically, imagine one plate on top of one brick. And if you're doing, you know, a whole city block, then you're using a lot of these plates. And again, they're $3.30 each. Adds up very, very fast. So it has cost us a lot of money to lay out our new city using the official Lego plates, which truthfully you never even see because they're below the city. Everything else is built on top of them. If we'd gone the Strictly Briks route, which I wish we had, we would have saved hundreds and hundreds of dollars, because these, again, are the equivalent of four of those plates for the exact same width spread out over 32 by 32. Studs. Now you also get some added benefit in there too, because since it's one solid piece, there's a little bit more stability in having four pieces. And they adhere perfectly to normal Lego bricks. I mean, I haven't had any issues whatsoever. They're snug, they're bendable, they literally feel just like Lego, but they're not. So again, I'm gonna leave a link down in the description below, so if you guys wanna try some of these for yourself, we do collect a small commission on that, but again, we would buy these with our own money. They're fantastic. I wish we had seen them sooner. We're building that new terrain area in our city, and we do intend to use these there. I think it's gonna solve a lot of problems we've been having with spending way too much money on the official Lego plates and being able to lay out a full new terrain area using these. They have really good green color, blue color, and we also have a fun project planned with Strictly Briks where we're gonna be rebuilding our airport. And if you recall, our airport also uses a lot of the official Lego 16x16 plates. But our thought is, if we can use some of the dark gray plates that Strictly Briks makes, we can lay out the airport that way, and it will probably end up saving a couple hundred dollars throughout the whole terminal. So more on that. We're still working with Strictly Briks to source some dark bluish gray plates for that, but we're really excited for that build. We're also gonna be including LED lighting in that, but we've partnered with a really cool company called Blinky Briks to bring the airport to life. So that'll be coming out in the next few weeks or month or so, so stay tuned for that. But we did wanna share our thoughts on the Strictly Briks base plates. These things are awesome. These were sent to us for free, full disclosure, but we're also gonna be buying some because they turned out a lot better than we were expecting. We get sent, you know, free stuff from time to time. We choose only to review stuff that we actually like. And this is definitely one of them. So check it out if your city is above ground using the new road plate system and you're looking for some cost saving measures. Again, these things go below the builds. So technically your whole city can still be true Lego to the naked eye since it sits below. But for us, we're gonna be using these going forward because it's gonna save a lot of money, especially with Lego increasing prices. So that's it for today. Hope you guys enjoyed the video and learning more about Strictly Briks. Again, it's a family owned company out of Wisconsin, so definitely love supporting small businesses. Thanks again for watching today's video. We'll see you next time.